Hello, YouTubers. What's going on? It's been a while since I've posted up another video. Right now, the missus and I are headed to a good friend of mine's wedding in Little Falls, Minnesota. So we're actually passing over the Manhattan Bridge right now to start our trek. If you would, missus, you can give them a quick view of what we got and what we're seeing ahead of us. Beautiful New York City. We're going to be leaving New York City and heading to the Midwest. It's been a while since we've been out there. It's been a while since I've been to Minnesota. And yeah, so sit back, relax, and we're going to show you the road trip. Talk to you soon.
Anything was possible. Hit cruise control and rub my eyes. The last 3 days and the rain was unstoppable. It was always cold, no sunshine.
Hey there, guys. We've finally made it into Little Falls, Minnesota. And the missus and I are walking around trying to see if there's anything to do. And I'll tell you what, it is barren in here. I forgot how slow the Midwest can be sometimes. But you guys posted, and yeah, we're in. We made it safely. It took us about 19 hours. So, yeah. Signing off.
Down this road, I'm picking up whatever's mine. I'm running down a dream that never would come to me. Working on a mystery, going wherever it leads. Running down a dream.
Now that was a road trip. Got back safe and sound, I had a blast, and what's even better is I had a great stack of comics here waiting for me. Please bear with me, I know a few of these issues, actually most of these issues are going to be out of order, but I still want to share them with you. So I'm going to start off with Marvel Team Up number 17. Get a great Gil Kane cover and Gil Kane pencils, script by Len Wein. And here we got Mr. Fantastic and Spider-Man going up against Basilic and Mole Man. And really cool thing here is you get to see Mole Man's agility, which I didn't know until recently. So this is a really cool book. Moving on, Marvel Team Up number 16. Once again, pencils by Gil Kane, but we get blessed by a cover by John Romita. And this is the actually beginning storyline of the previous book I just showed. where Captain Marvel gets stuck in his gem. But once again, a really cool Basilic and Mole Man story. Moving on, Marvel Team-Up number 43, and possibly one of my favorites I've read so far. Here you get Spider-Man and Doctor Doom, and this is one of the coolest Doctor Doom battles I've seen in a long time, mostly because he has such a hard time against this guy called the Dark Rider. And I don't know, maybe you guys can help me out here. I haven't really heard of the Dark Rider before or really seen that many other books with him. If you guys know a few more with him, I'd love to read them, so help me out and definitely gotta check it out. Cool cover by Gil Kane and a great book. Moving on, Marvel Team-Up number 41, pencils by Sal Buscema. Once again, Gil Kane cover. And this is where the Scarlet Witch goes back in time. It's really one of the worst places you can go back in time for a witch, for 1692 in Salem, Massachusetts. So it's a pretty cool issue as well. Now, since I've had these Astonishing Tales books, I've been really down with Kazar, and it doesn't stop here with Marvel Team-Up number 19. Kazar kills it. I mean, he outshines Spidey in this book by far. He, just like you can see in this cover, he tackles down a T-Rex and straight up gives him no other option, and he just puts him down. Puts him down with a knife. The cover shows it, the story does it. Great book. Now, moving on. We have Marvel Team-Up number 48, art by Sal Buscema. Once again, another cover by John Romita. I'm not the biggest Iron Man fan, but I am really digging these Marvel Team-Up books, so great to the collection. Once again, another Marvel Team-Up number 50. Here we get art by Sal Buscema, another Gil Kane cover. And I really dig anything with Doctor Strange, and I love how Doctor Strange and Spidey share hand symbols, so they work really well together, eh? Moving on, Marvel Team-Up number 56. Once again, Sal Buscema, covered by John Romita Jr. this time. Jr. gets a little bit in the mix, but it's a really cool Electro storyline, so really fun. Now, moving on to a little bit of Daredevil. Actually, the only Daredevil I have here is Frank Miller, script and pencils. This is a really cool storyline where Daredevil and Frank Castle take down a drug dealer, and they do not really see eye to eye on how to take him down. And Daredevil just takes him down with his own gun. Boom. Moving on, Iron Man, Invincible Iron Man 125, art by John Romita Jr. Once again, not a huge Iron Man fan, but this was a free book in the last one of the last orders I got, so I can't complain. Really cool. Moving on, X-Men 39. This is where the X-Men get their new costumes. I believe I actually might have already had this book, so this might be the second one I have. It's not in that much better shape. It's probably somewhere in good to very fine minus, I guess, but not bad for the collection. Amazing Spider-Man, number 82. I love this book. Script by Stan Lee, pencils by John Romita Sr. This is where J. Jonah Jameson hires Electro to basically try to unmask Spidey during a television broadcasting show. I forgot what it is. I don't know exactly what show it was, but I mean, J. Jonah is always hiring villains to go after Spidey. And what does that say about J. Jonah? But it goes horrifically wrong, and Spider-Man's there to help out. Moving on, we've got ASM number 52. We have the first appearance of Joe Robertson. Now, this was a free comic in one of the books or the lots that I just recently picked up. And it's in rough shape. Not bad shape. It's a great reader copy. And you can never turn down anything with pencils by John Romita, and obviously the script by Stan Lee, so great book. ASM 116, John Romita art, and you got a cool, I guess, he is cool. I kind of think of him as a Juggernaut kind of ripoff, but he kind of holds his own. Guy called the Smasher, really cool Gary Conway, and script with pencils by John Romita, the Smasher. Moving on with the ASM title, here we have number 81. script by Stan Lee, cool John Buscema art. Not my favorite Romita cover, mostly because, not because of the pencils, I mean, he did a great job with this, but I don't really like this kangaroo character, Kangaroo Jack, I'm going to call him from right now, which I know is wrong, but hey, it is what it is. It was worth it, because this lot gave me this one right here, number 8, or ASM number 77. This is another cover by John Romita, and this is probably one of my favorite Romita covers. You get a really cool script by John Buscema, and pencils on the inside are John Buscema, but the cover is what does it for me. It's the lizard, the human torch together. It's really dynamic. They're coming off the page. It's fantastic. Moving on, Amazing Spider-Man number 92. This is the second, I think I have two of these. Yeah, this is the second one I got. Normally I don't really go for doubles, especially if it's not in better condition, which this one really isn't. It's kind of matching it, but it came with the lot and it was a cheap lot. And I love the X-Men, so anything involved in the X-Men, and I love Spidey, involving Spidey, put those two together, I love it, it's fantastic, love the book. Moving on, ASM 111, I've been looking for this book for a while. I don't know if this book is that hard to find normally, or if I was just having a really hard time finding it, but I found it in a pretty good condition. I really did Kraven the Hunter as a villain. And Kazar makes an appearance, which rightfully so, anything with the jungle related, so really cool book. All right, now in last October, which was New York Comic Con, I actually submitted quite a few books, and this is the first time I've actually submitted books to CGC, and I just recently got 3 books back, and it's bittersweet because a few of them came back fantastic. This one itself came back in a little bit of a lesser grade than I thought it was going to come back in. It looked like it was going to be at least a 9-0. You know, there was maybe possibly little chips along the spine, but it looked great, and the back actually looked even better than the front, which is, I'm just really surprised. But nonetheless, and this is really one of the coolest books I have in my collection, and because it has not only a great Todd McFarlane cover, the first appearance of the black suit, but it's got, bam, it's got that great Todd McFarlane signature right there, so glad to have it. Now here's where the bitter and sweet kind of come into play. First, we'll start a little bit with the bitter. And this Captain America 100, I submitted it, and it came back partially restored. I'm not sure where, but I'm not going to dwell on it, because there's really a lot of sweetness in this book, and I kind of want to get this. I got this signature series in October, and this was right before the late great, and I do mean the late and great, Joe Simon, as we see her on the shield before he passed away, signed this book in such a great manner. And I can't think of another book I'd rather have it on. I really love this cover. It's got a great Kirby cover with some of my favorite Avengers, including the Black Panther and so on, and one of my favorite books. Now that we're on the topic of favorite books, here is my number one favorite book now in my collection. I've just received this back. This is a Silver Surfer number 4. It's written by Stan Lee, art by the great John Buscema and Sal Buscema. The cover, which is my favorite cover of all time, is done by John Buscema. And they say this is a low print run. I'm not quite sure about that, but it's 100% my favorite book in my collection. It has one of the most iconic battles between Thor and Silver Surfer, and I got it signed by, Stan Lee. Script by Stan Lee, art cover by John Buscema, and the book in my collection. Just in awe. Guys, this is where the journey ends. Sorry it took me so long to get a video up, but hopefully you really enjoyed this one. Thumb it up if you dig it, and I'll make sure that I don't take so long to put a next one up. So I'll catch you on the flip side. Peace, guys.